What's up, everybody? Welcome to day 269, Make It Songbringer. Today I'm working on making some level and overworld. Just patterns, these things that can fill up a blank area. So let's say an area like this had just a totally blank interior. This would be one of the patterns that I could put in it. This water isthmus, that's what this one's called. What's up, Pedro? Welcome, man. So I'm reworking this some pattern code, which I already had. What's up, Arcane? And then later on today, I'm going to be making some art and stuff and putting it on the overworld for points of interest. So first, just reworking this code. This is almost finished here. I'm going to work on this pattern for dots. Just got a simpler way of doing patterns, basically a function that can loop over all X and Y. I was really getting tired of always writing the same code over and over to loop over all of the X tiles and all of the Y tiles in an area. So I just made a function that takes either a lambda or any other kind of like function pointer or whatever. And it's really helped. It's really nice to have this rather than doing it the old way. It's just regular W with width. And regular H with height. The uniform grid. Oh, damn. Nice. Huh. What's the uniform grid do again? Does this line stuff up or something? Okay, this one is four dots. This puts four dots somewhere in the world. Oh, that's what speeds up the rendering? Oh, okay. Okay, so this should put up four different little rock tiles in this level. Oh, cool. We got some four dots. This one's dark because it doesn't have any lights in this one. Technically, all of these should have a chance to have some pillars. Like this. There's four dots. What's the next one? Diagonal lines, then switch. Before boss, boss. Boss on the side. And I think the last one is goal. Hello, Trevor. Welcome to today's stream. Pattern boss. Boss on the side. Before the boss. I'm working on little bits of little patterns. These are patterns that can go all over the overworld, all over levels, and these patterns can be reused to create flexible sort of interest points. And you'll see in a second, I'm about to run the game and it'll start making sense what I'm doing here. Switch has those two lights. Okay, so every one of these other patterns has in the levels has a chance to include lights. Yeah, this is gonna be this. What this will do is it'll just make the overworld a lot more interesting to play, because it'll have the overworld will have certain areas of the overworld are completely open. The interior of the area is completely open. It's like a blank canvas, ready to put on whatever kind of interesting pattern or interest point or secret or a store or something like that. And these patterns just basically make it more interesting when there's a blank area in the middle. So did I get all those? Looks like it. Except for connector. Oh, but I don't know if connect. I guess connector needs one too, yeah. And since I'm reusing that function all over the place, I'll do a little add sconces. Sconce. How do you spell sconces? Just one C, that's it. Add sconces. I'm debating whether to put. Nah, let's not even do that. Oh, yeah, I guess we could do an X delta and a Y delta. Whoa! That's a lot of objects. Yay, just Jeff, right on, man. Wow. That's a big speed up. All right, so I'm making a little function to reuse here. Which adds some sconces. Capture so height plus go H2 plus YD. Okay, so the original heights were 20, I believe. Yeah, I think 20. So 20 minus 3 would be 17, or yeah, so this is plus 7. This is just okay. So yeah, I can reuse this now. Add sconces. So the X delta is 6, the Y delta is 7 for pattern connector. The pattern we're running right now is 4 dots. Cool, you guys. Dude, I'm so stoked you guys are excited to play this. That's awesome. I'm really stoked to play it too. Oh, wait. This needs a if rand, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. Add sconces. Cool. Yeah, the rest of these patterns don't need it. Don't need it. Don't want. Yeah, game of the year. That would be great. That would be so awesome. Maybe I'll be nominated. Who knows? Maybe we'll win it one of these years. Cool. All right, now we got some sconces on this area. Awesome. Cool. So it's repeating that same pattern all over the place because, well, because I manually set it up here, so I want to do the next pattern, test it out. What's the next pattern to do? Diagonal lines. That turned out all right. It's getting easier to refactor all this. Diagonal lines done. I just realized I could make this an array of lambda functions to call. All right, cool. Now we got diagonal lines again. There was a bug in the code where it was when it was choosing the pattern for an area. It wasn't putting. Okay. By the way, can you guys hear the sound today? Let's see. You should be able to hear the sound from the game. Yeah, it looks like you can today. Good. I don't know what was up yesterday, but you couldn't hear the sound of the game the whole time. Well, what happened? Crashed the game. It's lagging? Did it just start lagging? Oh man, I don't know. Everything seems fine here on this end. Loeb, what's up, Loeb Music? Yeah, you got the sound running, working. Oh, cool. Yeah, Loeb, right? Yeah. So I'm using some better streaming software. It's called Game Show. I was using Open Broadcaster, and Open Broadcaster works for some people, but not for me. At least on Mac. And I tried every setting in the world. So, but anyways, Game Show works a lot better, has awesome audio quality. All right, we got diagonal lines again. Yeah, so this pattern basically was getting totally ignored. It was missed in the last alpha version. There was just absolutely no pattern diagonal lines. But now that I rewrote this code, I made sure to check that. And now we got diagonal line pattern again. That's pretty cool. So one more little pattern to use in the creation of levels to make things more interesting. And now that I've got all these separate little functions, everything's way easier in lambda functions. I can write more patterns to make it easier. So tile type is wall here. This is pattern switch. One tile wall. Tile wall. This is tile wall. This is not is X center. Is Y center. It puts a sky tile, wall tile, wall tile. Wait. Pattern switch. Here's the old one. Pattern switch. Oh, pattern switch just totally ignores it. So it returns. Okay. Pattern switch right here. We don't need to set that. Okay. And let's force this pattern to be pattern switch now. Cool. Yeah, so here's the switch pattern. Oh, something else is interesting. Check us out. Since last night, I've added the ability to catch your top hat. So you can throw your top hat. He catches it. I love that. That's pretty cool. Every direction. Yeah. And you can also pick up things now. If there's something on the ground, the character does this pickup animation. It's not working perfectly yet, though. Okay, switch pattern working good. Love it. Here's the before boss pattern. Whoops. All right, so this is a set tile wall. How much damage does the hat do? It's pretty light. It's the smallest damage that of anything. Pretty sure. Let's see. Top hat. Top hat damage. Yeah, it's half of a life heart basically, or half of a demon's tooth or whatever you want to call it. So that essentially works out to be in an integer value. That's two. So in integers, a whole heart or whatever is four. So that's half of a heart. So that's two. So yeah, it could do less damage. If it did one, it would be even less. But two is a pretty decent damage, I think, for the top hat. It's a really fun weapon to use, that's for sure. That's why you get it so early on in the game. Here's set tile wall, tet set tile wall. Otherwise, set tile rock. Okay, let's check this out. Before boss pattern. This one's pretty distinct. Just for fun, which yeah, it's also very useful. Did you see yesterday's video? I'll show you in a sec, actually. Oh, that's not quite right. Whoops. So I think I wasn't supposed to do this. Wait, well, okay, so pattern before boss else continue. Oh, continue would not do it. Okay, so yeah, this needs to return without. Else return. Wait, that doesn't make any sense. Doesn't make any sense. What did I? Wait. Tiles wall. Tiles wall. Otherwise, return. Oh. Okay. All right. Oh, sorry, Pedro. Good night, dude. I don't know what's up with the Twitch, but it's twitchy today. I blame it all on Twitch. Like that. That's what that should be like. Right. Okay, next one, pattern boss. Okay, let's make sure that looks good. We only got two more patterns to refactor here, and then we're off back to the overworld to play with some new patterns, create some new stuff to create interesting little patterns for the overworld. Right, here's the boss pattern. Fight the boss inside this room here. Okay, that's good. Next one, boss on side. This is a pattern where the boss is on either the left or the right side of the screen. See that? Make sure that looks good. That's what that's supposed to look like. Great. The last one is goal pattern. This one's totally different. It's got a tiny little platform in the middle of the screen, walkway, if you will. Yeah, man, this is great. Refactored. Okay. See this one? Make sure it's good. Was like, hey, it broke. Oh, but no, it didn't. It's all good. We got that platform in the middle of the screen here. Good. Refactor complete. What I don't need anymore is this code inside pattern level random where it's just doing this. It's filling in all these patterns. All this pattern code is now properly, and it's in the proper place, basically. And I've got a function I can call called thisAddPattern, which I can, you know, conditionally create these patterns if I want to in a certain pattern function. And it looks like this should also be inside those patterns. What's up, Boogie? All right, so yeah, add this to the pattern for goal, pattern goal. At the end, we know this is pattern goal, so just add the teleport field, stairs position. I wonder what that'll do to this screen where we shouldn't have a stairs position. It probably won't do anything. Oh, it did. It added one. Okay. I can live with that. Where's it warp me to, though? Whoa. Where am I now? That was weird. Okay. But it essentially does the right thing there. Okay, so I think that function is now cleaned up. Pattern connect, no, pattern level random. Looks like we don't need H2 anymore. You've been playing Axiom Verge? Nice. Right on. I love Axiom Verge. I still got to get Ori in the Blind Forest. How are you liking it, man? How far are you into it? Oh, yeah. It's pretty far. Loving it. Nice. It's a good game. If anybody's watching the stream, you haven't played Axiom Verge, highly recommend it. It's pretty cool. It's a freaking awesome Metroid-style game. And it's made by one guy. One guy made all the art, all the music, and all the code. It's like my hero. Thomas Happ. Thanks, Thomas Happ. Thanks for making Axiom Verge. I actually sent an email to that guy. I was like, Thomas Happ, you're awesome. Thank you. You're an inspiration. But I didn't get a reply. I might have guessed his email wrong. There. Oh, we're still not even using H2 though. All right. There. And this should be like pattern add walls or something like that. I know, right? That would be pretty cool. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna take a quick break. Be right back. Spot foo. What's up?
Shavings?
Ah!
No! Savings!
Oops. No, don't play that. Oops. Oops! Oh, how do I get rid of this? I played one of my my old videos or something. I think it's only gonna play 6 minutes of it. Savings? Yes! Oh, I've been waiting my whole life for savings. That's all I want. I just want some savings. Wait tight. Oh. Don't need that till here. Alright, nice. This should probably be a draw walls function. Add walls, maybe. But, yeah, I'm gonna get back to doing the patterns. Overworld, so I can check this in at this point. I forgot to add these. All right, so since this morning, here's the code I've been writing. That's some code that allows God mode to run everywhere on the overworld. Fixed up creating items. Got this new for each tile function. Patterns are being placed on the overworld. I got a new DRAN function. Yeah, all good. All good. There's one more thing to add there. Pattern blank. Also none. Oh, I guess I've added a few more of these. I think K pattern overworld. We can simplify that. Just call it K pattern. And add these three to the constants.cpp. So these can be specified in a data file rather than in the game, hard coded. Here we go. Cool. So we'll run this and not have any bugs. Any compile bug, compile time errors. All right, yeah, so this I can check in. Loving it. All right, so back to the overworld. In fact, I kind of like wherever the heck it warped me to there a second ago. It's a good place to start. Right, so I'm gonna go into God mode and find some areas to play with. Oh, look at that. Ooh, that's weird. What is happening here? Kind of like it, whatever this is. So what area is that? Area 110. Oh, this did the pattern. Oh. Can't believe I checked that in. Area patterns. The add pattern function doesn't. Shouldn't be forcing every pattern to be goal. There we go. All right, here we go. This is a pattern. This one is called tree with a pond. I can go into God mode and play around, see what kind of patterns we get. Wonder what pattern that is. That's interesting. Okay, here's one that could be potentially a dangerous pattern. Because if it puts too much water in this kind of area, then this could very well block a path. So I'm gonna save it right there and work on this tree pond pattern. Yeah, success. Tech support with dad, success. Okay, so putting this pattern, so the goal for this is, yeah, it has been freezing. I don't know what's up, but it's been freezing for Pedro and some other people. I don't know what's up. So placing this shape. The exterior of this shape, the edges around the top of this shape, need to guaranteed be open. I guess I can make a function that checks. It checks over a rectangle. And I guess I could do other shapes too and check all the shapes. I guess I could create a function called canFitShape. What's up, J2? Welcome, man. I'm working on making patterns for the overworld. So here's a pattern that I've run across. This is a pattern with a tree in the middle and a little pond. But there's a potential danger with this type of shape in that it could possibly block the area from being traversed. Like right here, it's a pretty good example of where it can block it. If it was just a few more, it would be blocked right there. Oh, but I am checking his open interior. I guess I could just make them so they're not quite as deep. Right? Yeah, doesn't it? Like, what is this little thing in the middle of this pond? How about instead of, yeah, I'll make these smaller ponds, because I know this area is guaranteed to have a completely open interior. That's why these patterns are even being applied. So I guess it would be okay as long as this area is completely open on the inside and the pond is a little smaller. Yeah, so that'll do. That's like the maximum size right there. Cool. Okay, so back to God modes, run around, see what we've got. Oh, whoops. This keeps on saving God mode. Oh. So here's one that's this wrong. Okay, so an open interior doesn't necessarily mean that this level has... Yeah, I do need some kind of fit tile shape type thing. Okay, save here. It's a great example of an area that needs to check its boundaries before it places a shape. Okay, I'm going to make a function, a simple function, that only works on rectangles for now. And it'll just say, this is like, so this will be R tiles. Oh, I started running your own camera? Nice. Cool, man. Yeah. Custom camera and Kokos. Okay, so given a point, a tile position, and width height tile, this function is going to loop over all those tiles. And tell whether they're all that given tile type. Oh, I guess I can make two versions of this function. And this might as well be up here with isTile, it's a lot like them. And yeah, I might as well pass in XY instead of those. So int XY width height. Yeah, this kind of implies that it's a centered position. Actually, now it's totally implied. Center. And these are all center. Oh, and this is a const vector tile types. Yeah, it did. It ripped. The thing ripped itself. Oh no, it's now it's doing it again, reconnecting. Is it going to stay on? We've been streaming a whole 15 seconds now. Thirty seconds with no interruption. Nobody breathe. Idea, puzzle where you need to go over water, but to achieve this, you need to blow up. Oh, rock near it. Oh, and the shards will make a bridge. Interesting. I like that. Or a tree. Right. Oh, a tree. Yeah, you could knock down a tree and it could become a log. Right. You have to unlock the beaver item. Oh, yeah. Oh, cool. Rip again. God damn. Idea, make the stream stop ripping. I don't know, man. I think it's Twitch's servers because my internet's fine today and it just keeps reconnecting to Twitch. Does it do that every time? Every time it restarts the stream, you get an email? Good God. Oh, it's doing it again. Oh, what to do? What to do? Oh, should I keep streaming? I don't want to spam everybody's e emails. Oh, you've only got one email? Well, that's good. But watch, in like 5 minutes, you're going to get like 50 emails. Don't know. I'm going to go ahead and thoroughly place the blame on Twitch with this one. All right, well, oh, push notifications to your phone, that's great. Oh, yeah. Okay, well, anyways, if this keeps happening and it's really annoying for everybody watching the stream, I might stop it early. I hope I don't have to, though. All right, so the whole point of this method is to go if this is not this current tile, which is going to be pause.x plus x, pause.y plus y. If it isn't the vector of those tiles, return false. Okay, cool. All right, all right. Otherwise, return true. There. This is just a rectangular method which checks an area to make sure it's all a given tile type. So you could pass in a tile type of tile none, and that would say that, okay, this whole area is free and clear. All right, so back to area patterns, where we are creating pattern for the, not the rock pile, but the tree pond, right? This is the tree pond one? Let's check that. No, this is the rock pile. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is check the rock pile to make sure that its shape can be... certain size. Okay, so I need a smart method which chooses, well, first of all, let's make sure this function works. So if not this R tiles, the center is going to be right there. The width is 3, or actually, this is the width. This is the height. Oh, so I need to check if it's all none. There we go. So yeah, checking to make sure every single tile. Oh, that needs to be +1 though. So width +1, height +1. If that's all none, put that pattern. Otherwise, don't put the pattern. Oops, got a bug. What? Oh, look at this. It's just calling itself recursively forever and ever and ever. Why did it do that? Okay, I'm checking this R tiles, passed in none. Stepping into this method. It just keeps calling itself. Okay. That's curious. But this did not, somehow, that did not call itself. Oh well. It's probably better to write this function without this method anyways. Let's clear that out, get rid of that one. Area.h, rtiles only has the vector version. It's kind of more of a hefty function, so we can have that vector version. Born to Snipe, what's up? Cool, you made a val tree for Java? Nice, man. Right on, dude. I'll include you in the link to that. Let me save a link to your project on GitHub. Sweet, dude. Awesome. What's that again? Born to Snipe, Valtry. That didn't work. GitHub.com/born to snipe foul tree. Sweet. How'd you write it? Source. Let's check out some source. Sweet, man. Cool. That's awesome. Looks like I was streaming that whole time. All right, great. We got one error now because we're probably calling it without the vector. True. Okay, so we need this to be a vector. And now it shouldn't put that shape there because it should not be able to fit it. Assuming this whole function is hunky dory. Oh, it didn't work. Maybe a little more. I guess plus two because that would be, yeah, might need to be plus two on each end. Oh, what? Looks like I might need to stash this area. Area pause. Yeah, there's something wrong with this though. What area pause is this? 510. We'll set a breakpoint here for that. So if area pause. Here we go. Okay, so let's inspect this method. What's wrong? Why didn't that work? Right, so position should be right in the middle, 10, 9, that's correct. Width is 7, height's 5. This R tiles. W2, W is 11, height's 9, 5, 4. Y is negative H2, less than H2. X negative positive. If not, this is tile. Pause dot X plus X. Oh, wait a minute. It could be doing this before it's added the quadrants pattern connector. Oh, yeah. See, it hasn't added the quadrants yet. All right. So in area patterns, here we need to run the add the patterns after we've added the quadrants or a fill. Turn this off. Yeah, cool. It stopped it from running that time. Yay, look at that. Got open area here now. It proves that it's checking that right. But let's check this also. I think it's just, if we just plus one, it might not, it might allow that. No, it didn't allow it. Cool. So, but if I do just zero, it should allow that and be like, oh yeah, all these tiles right here in the middle are blank. Yeah. Awesome. So I think the safest bet here is to keep these as plus two. Or we could just set the width to be something small. That didn't work. Why didn't that work? What? Oh, it is a shaped circle. Shaped circle is broken right now. If it is shaped rectangle. Yay, we have a rectangular shape in the middle of this. Okay, but circular would be cool to implement as well. So let's try a circle now. Put that back to circle. What's up, Toxic Waste? You're learning code. Good for you, man. It's awesome. Code's a powerful tool. Nice, man. Good for you. You're only 12 years old. That's awesome, man. What coding language are you using right now or learning? Right? Cool. So what language? All right. I'm trying to be able to draw circ I'm draw ovals with this circular shape. It's basically a circular shape that I can specify the width or height of, which can create an oval. Looks like we're not fitting an oval at all right there. Or it is fitting an oval. All right, man. Cool. Good for you. Keep going, man. Have you seen the extra credits videos? I'll post you a link here for them. So let's try doing a perfect circle there with this three. It's not working. Oh, this probably needs to be less than or equal to R. I get how this needs to be less than or equal to R. What's up, Big Mac Dev? It's a custom Xcode theme that I made, but I did release it on Gist. Let me get the link for that for you. If you just go to my Gist, it is. So link I gotta post. Let me. There you go. Okay, so does that work? That less than or equal to? No, it still doesn't draw a circle. I need to go back to circle school. You're welcome, man. All right, I guess I gotta put this test back in here. If area pause B3I 510. Circle school. Seriously. I think I missed that day. My teacher sent me home sick that day. It's gotta be what it was. Okay, we're about to draw a circle. It's got a width of 3 by 3 for size. The X ratio is 1, the Y ratio is 1, the R is going to be 3. Now XX. Oh, this would be a lot easier to debug if I set the distance right here. Yes, circle's cool. Seriously, where did all my geometry skills go? Shouldn't I be using sine and cosine here? So I wasn't using, thanks man. I wasn't using sine and cosine because I wanted to squish the circle and make it an oval. Okay, we're at the first position. This is negative 3, negative 3. This should not be within the circle's distance. This is get tile dist of that. Distance is 9. That can't be right. 9? Wait a minute. Is that right? 3 squared plus 3 squared is 18. 18 square root is 4.24. Let's see this one more time. Okay, we got XX this time. Oh. Clear. It's clear why this is wrong. This needs to be the tile distance from XX to the center point, which is really just, oh yeah, this is fine. Just pause that X, pause that Y. There. Let's see if it works now. Gladiar, what's up, man? Working on some patterns for the overworld. Okay, good. There, we've got it. Whoa, that's a little bit big, though. I guess that needs to be less than R now. Yeah. There we go, now we've got a 3x3, but this should have shaved off those edges. It didn't. Yes, I did. Yep, changed the color scheme. Okay, so this should be drawing a circle, but it doesn't seem like it is. But let's play with it. Let's set make it really wide and see if we get kind of an oval shape. What's up, Spymort? Yeah, there's been music for a while. Yeah, this game's, man, it's been a while since you've been on, man. Oh, what happened here? Okay, so we were supposed to have a circle, but now we have some bunch of random strips. This is crazy. Crazy, man. Okay, breakpoint's on again. Let's find out why that's suddenly gone crazy. So what I'm working on here, what I'm working on in general, I'm working on patterns. Yeah. I'm working on patterns for the overworld. So the pattern I'm working on here is something where you'll have a little, some kind of shape here in the middle of the screen. That's all it is. These guys are tough. So yeah, this shape is all broken right now, but these are supposed to be nice little shapes. Yeah, so how you been, Gladiar? Alright, once again, breakpoints on. We'll figure out what's up with this drawing circle method, drawing some random lines. Okay, XX, negative 6. YY is 6? Wait, okay, XX shouldn't be like that. So XX is a product of, it's a pause, position's 10, 10 plus X ratio times X. X ratio, oh, it's X ratio is 2.33. Not sure there needs to be a okay, I think this needs to be X ratio is 1, Y ratio is 1. If width is height is less than width, then the Y ratio is height over width, else X ratio is width over height. Hey, what's up, Joel Kreutz? I'm good, man. How are you? Oh, that's right. Your laptop got stolen, man. Oh. Cool. Wow. Nice, dude. Nice coding exploration. All right, so we've got a width of 7, a height of 3, and we got a Y ratio 0.42, X ratio 1. I think that's correct now. Now XX is 3, YY is 6, distance from the center, something reasonable, 7, yeah. Okay, I think we're looking okay now. Ah! Broke everything. You blew it! No wait, that might have actually been okay. That might actually be okay. So like for example, if we went 5, we need an area for this. I think. Well, let's do 3-3, see if we get a nice circle that way. We should see some edges of this circle being cut off, you know. Ah. Worked. Stream, yeah, the stream's going crazy today. Sorry about that, guys. It's going in and out here on my end. Apparently my internet's okay today, but I think something's wrong with Twitch's servers or something. It keeps kicking me off and then it reconnects. So sorry about that, but yeah, just I don't know what's up with the stream quality today, but there's nothing really I can do. So, sorry about that. What if the width was 1? Oh, wait a minute. R is supposed to be a max of W2 or H2. Ah, that's probably why we don't have circles working. This is my circle school right here. Radius, it's half. Yay, there, it's a 1x1 should be only one tile right here. That's what that turned out to be. What's next for Songbringer? Dungeons, more interesting overworld, more enemies. Working on the huge list. Yes, I still have a huge list. I'm still adding cool stuff, yeah. I'm trying not to work so much on the list and work more on the cool stuff. Yeah, I'm hiding it. I am. I'm purposely hiding the bugs list and the ideas.txt. Just because I don't want to look at it. There's so many things on there. And there's so much stuff I know I already have to do. It's like super fundamental, so... Yeah, I'm just kind of going with my heart flow, you know, just flowing, creating, and then I will get to the point where I'll be like, okay, I got to get to the list. But hopefully by then, a lot of the things will naturally have kind of gotten off the list because I along the way, I'm fixing a lot of bugs. That was 1x3. Yes, yeah, I have improved the camera movement. It follows the player a little bit. It's really slight, and it also wanders a little bit. So if I just stand here, you'll notice that it does just slightly move. Kind of makes everything feel really alive. My thoughts on Swift being open source, I think it's great that they're moving more in an open source direction. I just, you know, it'll be for a new language like that to get adopted though, and really be a good cross-platform language. It's going to take years. You know, there's a lot of other compilers that need to have, you know, great Swift support for it to be a viable engine for cross-platform development. So yeah, I just think that it boils down to cross-platform for me in a lot of senses on what engine I'm going to use or language. So if it doesn't have cross-platform support, it's not something I would use because I want my game to run on as many platforms as possible. When's the beta? I don't have a date for that yet. Right now I'm doing lots of updates to the alpha versions. I'm going to do another update to the alpha version this month. And then, yeah, when the game's ready... When it has all the dungeons and all the bosses finished, that's about the point when beta will hit. And so I don't really know how long that's going to take to get all those bosses done and stuff, and levels and dungeons and stuff. So it might be a few months before that. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's not working, but maybe this is. If we do a 3x3, we should have the corners kind of chopped off. Oh, no, that didn't work. Damn. So what if we went 5x5?
Hi, babe.
What's up, baby? What's Facebook React Native? Is that Facebook I'm reading there? 5x5, is that done working either? Yeah, 5x5 is 3. So I guess it R now does need to be less than or equal. Circle school. Going back to circle school. Yeah, less than or equal to. Oh, yeah. But did it die again? Yeah, it did. Sorry, guys. Still not a perfect circle. Ah. I want to get to an area. It's easier. Let's do the tree pond and make that a circle. I know. Okay. Where's there's this one area that was really friendly? Ah, here it is. Oh, okay, cool. Oh, it did work. Barely. It's got this one little edge right there. Okay, so let's put this into some WH values. There's small black bars at the side. Are you playing? You're playing the alpha version? It's probably just the camera. I might have messed up on the camera in the last version. A little bit. Did I have any Cocos 2DX contributions going, or is it working just fine? I don't know what you mean by that. Okay, yeah, so it's the alpha version. Yeah, a lot's changed since then. But I do remember back then. Man. Is there any way you could send me a screenshot of that? Because I don't, I'm making assumptions here. You know, I'm trying to guess what the problem is. But if I saw a picture of a screenshot of your screen, that would really help. You can always email me it if you're, or just, post it right now or whatever. But nad@wizardfoo is my email. I think we've communicated before on email, right? Oh, right. Oh, yeah. I haven't contributed to Kogosudi X in a while, but I guess the most recent thing I've been contributing is Valtry. I released a whole data format online. You can it just parses data. It's called Valtry, and then I also published Entity Foo. Yeah, no, I don't. I'm not using Kogosudi X's lighting anyways. This is a totally custom thing. It uses shaders, so I wrote some shaders to do all the lighting in the game. Awesome. Cool, right on. Okay, what I'm trying to do here is make a circle. Oh yeah, that's right. Yeah. Sorry. I get a lot of names here on the chat, so. Right, cool, man. Yeah, dude, things have been changing a lot since the alpha version. I can't wait to get the new version in your hands. Okay, so this time I didn't even draw. What if we do a bigger circle? And we'll take away the bounds checking as well. Right, that worked, except. It did a square, not a circle. So it didn't work. Okay, we'll set a breakpoint. Run it to here. Check out this pattern shape. No breakpoint? What's the. Oh, it's good. Oh, whoops. Just quit Xcode. It is. It's gaining consciousness. Simpler to read? Yes, I have been. I've been doing a lot of stuff for that in the world. So check this out. The world has is now getting to be a lot more data driven. So for example, this is like a section of the world called the overworld. You can specify your maze stuff, your ground textures, and then entities. This is the coolest part here, is these entities. You can specify all these entity types, and then my code for actually reading and creating entities reads all the entity types from the data, and then it can say, okay, this type of entity has this image, this color, this type of collision boundary, this shadow, whatever. Everything can be loaded from data really well now. So there's a lot more work to do to implement this all. I mean, to kind of re-implement, refactor the code to be using this. But this system is going to be re is really, really good foundation for ha having to write less code. Basically, just making things way more data-driven and less reliant on writing new code. So there's that, and that's really awesome. It'll basically make it really fast to create new worlds. Like if I wanted to go create a totally different new dungeon, all I would have to do is copy an existing dungeon and then start a new one, It would, and I could have totally different art in like a day rather than taking like a week or whatever to recode it all. And the added benefit is this is really awesome for people that are going to mod the game because it's just super simple. It's all already in the data. You can change anything. You can change the size of a rock. You know, you could change what kind of blocks are bombed, you know? Okay, so I'm trying to draw a circle, and this circle is not working. But what I'm trying to do is draw actually an oval. I'm trying to draw a circle that has a certain size. So what area is this? Is area 2, 0. So set a breakpoint here, 2, 0. All right, we got the breakpoint. Let's go jump into, oops, I stepped over pattern shape. Oops. Right. Yeah, I'm not sure if I'm even gonna take that step of making it encrypted. Yeah, I might just leave it totally open so it's easy to mod. And what it'll do though is to make it fair for everyone, if it'll detect if the engine has been or if any of the data has been modded. So basically when I release this game, I'll put some kind of checksum, right? It'll go and it'll checksum all of the text files, all of the data, and therefore it can quickly know whether any of the data has been changed, you know? So that way, when you do run a modded version of Songbringer, it's not going to try and upload your scores to the leaderboards or anything like that, you know? It'll be fair. So if you do want to score on the leaderboards, you have to play a non-modded version. Thank you! Thanks for sending that over, man. I'll take a look at that and see if it is the camera or if maybe it's something else. It might be the window, you know? So cheers, I really appreciate that. And I am, like I said, I am gonna be updating the alpha version sometime this month, probably towards the end of the month. So yeah, I'll announce it and everything, and there'll be an updated alpha version, and all you gotta do is go to Steam and it'll just automatically update it. Yeah. Okay. What? Oh, missed it again. Okay. I want a circular circle. I want a non-rectangular circle. Okay, R, we've got a width of 5, a height of 5, the radius of this circle is 2, I guess so. Awesome, man. Yeah, X ratio, Y ratio, both 1. Yes. Oh man, that would be kind of cool. I was just thinking if you could play, or if I could stream Songbringer and have people mod the game, like real time. But now we're getting really complicated. I don't want to take a year just to write that. Okay. What's this XX, YY? X and Y are -2, -2. The distance for that is 2. Oh, thanks, Gladiator. No worries, man. Feel free to ask any kind of questions anytime. Right, yeah. Yeah, exactly. Live modding. Twitch plays Songbringer where they change the game. That would be insane. Okay, so is that right? 2 squared plus 2 squared is 8. The square root of 8 is 2.8. Oh, so this should be like, should be rounded. Get tile this area.cpp. Oh, it already is floating point. Okay, never mind. So back in here, we just want to go, the int distance is the L rounded version of that. Right. Yeah. Twitch plays Songbringer. All right, now we got x, y, -2, -2. Distance, 3, good. It's just beyond the bounds. Next up, we have -2, -1. The distance is 2. It's gonna allow that. Okay, well, let's see this. Yeah, there we go. Now we've got a circle, sort of. Okay, now let's go back and do a bigger one. And make sure this is a circle. All right, yay. Got even more of a circle. Let's do a bigger one. All right. That's looking good too. We got a radius of 9 now on this circle. Next up, let's make sure it can create, it can squish the circles. What's up, Friday Night Gaming? I'm making, what kind of game are you making? It's a game kind of like Zelda. The first Zelda, the original Zelda. So if I squish the width and make a width smaller than the height, it should still be able to draw a circular shape given these parameters. Thanks, Boogie. Okay, we got a circle, but it's not really the right shape. Oh, maybe it needs to be rounded and stuff in the. It might need to be just rounded.
We're leaving at 6:15 to go grab
it. Oh, what time is it? 4:30? Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, there's time. All right, thanks, babe. Oh, you never noticed the grass? Yeah, the grass is fun. It's a really fun thing. It's just like, it was one of those days where on the stream I was like, hey, let's do some. Well, I was doing the grass already, but then somebody suggested that some money should pop out when you when you're walking over grass, and it turned into one of the, I love it. It's one of the funnest features of the game, I think. I love trampling the grass. It's like, yeah, I want to trample it all. Oh, check this out too. If you walk really slowly, let's see if we can get it to happen. If you walk really slowly and you get an item, it'll actually bend over and pick it up. Get an item. Yeah, there you go. So I need to work on the art for it and stuff, but there's also this, so you can catch your top hat now. If you're standing in one place. So yeah, lots of little adjustments lately. Yeah. Okay, so the something's wrong still with the circle when I do a squished shape. It shouldn't I don't know what's up with that squish shaping shape. Inspector Columbo. Actually, she has. She's been on one of the streams. Just one of them. I'm not going to say which one. Because now you have to go try and search through every single one of them. But yeah, she's there. She's there. She's here. She's amazing. So it looks like the X. Oh, because it's adding X. Man, I don't think I'm gonna keep on doing this right now. I wanna have fun with this, and I wanted to create more shapes. I know, right? Yeah, it's a lot. Yeah, okay, let's just draw some cool shapes now. We got a circle that's working. So, rejoice. Let's have some fun. So I'm going to do a circle shape here. We should still have this circle shape. Friday Night Gaming, yes, I can release it on Android. And if I can get the funding, that's going to happen. Thanks, man. Glad you liked the trailer. Okay, what happened here? Oh, this is the other way around. It's supposed to be there. Okay, I think we're good. We've got a little pond and a tree. And the pond can be circular. All right, cool. So this is going to be almost it for the stream today. Friday Night Gaming, yes, I am a lone wolf. I make the art, I make the music, I make the code. I do the business, I do everything. So it takes me longer to do stuff that other teams can do way quicker, but it is really rewarding that I can create it all myself and create an aesthetic that is exactly what I want, you know? Like, I want this game to feel exactly like this, you know? And I don't have to go collaborate with anyone or try and communicate that vision to anyone else. I just go do it, and it's really, really fun. But I'm not totally alone. I have people here on the stream. You know, you guys are always watching and commenting, and I've gotten a lot of incredible feedback just from people watching the stream, so that's awesome. So now I'm gonna run around the world and check out some of the little interest points that it's put. So this is one of the interest points. It put a little pond with a tree in the middle. Oh, it'd be nice to randomize this, so maybe it could do a pillar. Yeah, let's do a pillar maybe on randomly. So tree pond, if yes, plus one for the chat. Thank you, chat. And also thank you all the Kickstarter backers and everyone that's pre-ordered the game. You guys are making this game happen, literally. This game wouldn't have happened without the Kickstarter. So, man, thank you again. I get to make a game however the hell I want because of you amazing backers. All right, so set tile, K tile tree. Let's do random chance to do maybe a gargoyle tile. Yeah, gargoyle tiles could work here. So if this get rand at our position, let's grab this into an R variable too. So auto R. R is less than 128. We'll do K tile tree. Otherwise, we'll do K tile gargoyle. Or a bird. What's up, Rocket Bunny? Yeah, definitely. Magic, for sure. And I wrote a, what's up, Lighter Thief? Yo, dude. Gladiar, I wrote a post on Gama Sutra about how to do a Kickstarter. So there's that. It's, if you just search for Gama Sutra Nathaniel Weiss, you'll find my article or the cure for, I think it's called the cure for indie game failure. But basically the theory behind it is that you, you should, every game you make, if you want to be successful with it financially, you should verify that people want to buy it before you spend years making it. What's this project? Yeah, so it does seem, right? It does, sometimes it does seem really unfair, like that some projects make less than others and stuff. But you can't really compare two teams' fan bases. You know, the following that a game has before you launch a Kickstarter has a lot to do with how much the game raises. Also, another huge thing that has to do with how much a game raises is how many people are on that team. You know, when you're looking at a Kickstarter, typically you'll go and look at how big the team is or whatever. And so basically it makes more sense for more people to give to a project that needs it than people that, you know, a project that doesn't. 15 grand was kind of all I really needed. So it was everything I needed and it was awesome. And for them, 75 grand might be just what they need. You know, that might be a small amount to them. So nice, you got your Christmas tree. Yes, we celebrate Christmas. We have a Christmas tree as well. Oh, I guess Gama Sutra, maybe? Or Gama, yeah. Thanks, Boogie. Oh, right, well, or crowdfunding, maybe? Or Kickstarter? All right, so this should have a random chance to make these tree pawns a gargoyle. Nice, crowdfunding. So cool, dude, I love you, Bopfu. Right? Okay, so that now should have a random chance for that to be a gargoyle tile. Let's run around the world and see if we can find some gargoyle tiles. Nothing? Not finding anything here. Let's set R to just be Z, not zero, but oh, I used the wrong function. It's supposed to be get ran one. Oh, there we go. Yeah. Thanks, Ladyar. Oh yeah, there's a lot of new enemies. Hey there, cool, we've got a gargoyle tile. So yeah, anybody that's just joining the stream, I'm about to shut the stream down. Actually, yeah, this is probably it right here. But what I did today was I made these sort of interesting bits of the overworld. Like, this is like an area where the overworld recognized that this had a totally open area in the middle. There's, like, potential. There's potential here. There's an opportunity to put something interesting on this level. So it said, okay, I'm going to put a tree pond with something in the middle right here. And actually on this screen, it put some rocks. And here's, it puts another gargoyle tile. So yeah, I'm just gonna play around with these like a little bit. You know, some of these will have gargoyles, some of them will be trees. Some of them, I'm gonna draw some new stuff. Maybe I'll draw some stuff tonight. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. Turd flying? Yeah, when he's like this? Yeah, that'd be cool. What are the black balls? Okay, they're nothing yet, but they are going to be something. There's going to be a secret to those. And so, yeah, spoiler alert there. Those are secrets. But I haven't spoiled it yet. Nice rocket bunny. Okay, so yeah, that's it for today's stream. I'll be back tomorrow, Wizard 30. Oh, maybe tomorrow. Tomorrow's Sunday. I might take a day off. But yeah, so that's it. Thank you guys a lot. Thanks for watching. Thanks again for backing and all the incredible support. Just watching the stream, I think, is really nice of you guys to support this project or watch it. And I hope you learn stuff. I hope it's amazing. So yeah, catch you next time. Nice.